Well, I got a football scholarship. That's how I got here. And she followed me, even though she didn't know me, but she knew I would be here.
No, I didn't.
So I was always on the flat surface. I said, well, I want to see the mountains. I want to see something different.
Well, the sky was black and white. God hadn't painted it blue and white yet. Grass wasn't painted green. It was all...
It was very safe. I do remember that.
Yeah, it was a beautiful campus.
The center of campus was where the new part is now. Okay, there was a place called the Townhouse, which still existed.
Now, I grew up there where a stadium was a standalone building by itself. And we walk behind the library, he said, look over to your right. I see this grassy field. I said, what's this? He said, that's the stadium. The concrete seats on the home side and had the little bleachers they put on the visitor side.
Hunter Library was, of course, a lot smaller. None of the buildings were here. Stillwell was still here.
Up until my freshman year, Western did not allow any alcohol on campus. North Carolina's legislature had passed the law the year before, I guess, that said that if you were 18 years old, you could drink beer. But you couldn't have any more than either two or three cases per student in your room at one time. Oh my goodness.
The beer bash that was always over there on K.A. Hill, everybody remembers that. I mean, just, it was a knockout.
So you'd see all these windows with these beer cans all along them, because that's how people would keep it cold in the winter, yeah. In the wintertime.
That's when streaking was going on. We had the record for the longest or biggest streaking contest until University of North Carolina got mad and decided to have more people.
Putting towels against all of the doors in Benton Hall and putting about an inch of water in there and a lot of soap in there, and playing hall hockey with brooms and a tennis ball, which was great fun. I don't recommend it nowadays.
When they first started the Tuckasegee River Raft Race, we always went tubing down there, and then they made it a big event. People from other campuses showing up, and oh, that was something.
If you've been gone 20 years and you haven't been to the campus, first thing, you're going to come back and you're going to go, whoa, I can't even figure out where I'm at on campus, you know? I mean, it's a shock.
But if it's anyway half as good as it was when I was here, 11,000 students are going to be very happy.
I do know that there is something special about Western. Everybody that goes here seems to always love it and come back. I mean, because, it's a little community all its own.
When I think about Western, I think about one word, and that's opportunity.
Most people here are first-generation college kids. When we came here, that they don't have anything to give. But, you know, you don't have to be alive. Everybody gave about $10 a year. By everybody who graduated from Western, we could probably meet a lot of our goals and do what we have to do.
It gives me a chance to publicly say how much I love this institution and how much it's meant to me and the opportunities it's made available and that it's still making available for anybody who's willing to step forward and do it.